Hey guys, welcome to another Visual Basic Games Programming tutorial. This is a request made by one of our subscribers wanting to see a high score system implemented as part of the game that I made a while ago, Magic Monk Adventures. So just to recap you guys on what I have made so far in that game was so basically this is the main title screen, and then you can click start game, and then you move your character around collecting the blue gems, dodging the red bugs, and if you die three times, so 1, 2, 3, it tells you that the game is over and you can see a high score of 5. And then if you play again and you beat that high score, so you beat that high score, let's get to 6, 7, okay, so you, if you die 3 times, then the high score turns into 7. But the problem with that is, if you close down the game and you open up the game again, it resets the high score. So the high score is not there anymore. So what we want to do is find a way so that we can store the high score in a text file, and then it's gonna load up that text file every time we play the game, so that we can see what the previous high score was. So here are the steps required to get this high score system into our game. The first step is, if your score beats the high score at the end of the game, then it's going to ask you to input your name into the program. And what we're going to do with that is store your name as well as the score into the text file, which is step 2. So we're going to store your high score and your player name to a text file. And then step 3, at the beginning of the game, we're going to load your high score and your name from the text file. Now this will only occur, saving your score to the file, if your score beats the previous high score. Alright, so otherwise it won't do it. It'll just have the previous high scorer saved in that file. It won't modify that file any further. Okay, so let's try to get this to work. Now let's bring up Visual Basic, and the first thing we're going to do is declare a variable called player name, and we're going to declare as a string variable with nothing in it, an empty string. Okay, and then we're going to also have in our form a label to display this variable. So I'm going to create another label, put it on the screen, and instead of label 1, I'm going to call it name label. So I'm going to call this where is the name property? Instead of label 1, I'm going to call this name label, and I'm going to change the font size to 14. So font size, change that to 14, so it's a bit bigger, line it up with the other labels, and the text, the intro text is going to be player name. So player name, so I should say best player, right, because this is the best player so far. Okay, so when you load up the game, actually, I'm going to make it save the ask you to input your name after at the end of the game. So go back to form one, go into the coding, and go down to the timer one tick event handler. So scroll all the way down to where it says timer one tick, and then go down to where it says if lives equals zero. So that means the game has ended, right? You're gonna display the message box game over, and if your score is bigger than the high score, we also want your name. So player name is equal to, and we're gonna get this via an input box, and it's just gonna ask them to enter your name. So we have their name in the player name variable, and then we're gonna display it in our label. So the label is gonna say best player, and it's gonna also display the player name at the end of that string. Now, as you know, my theory is do a little bit at a time, make sure that it works. So let's click start debugging, and we just want to see that after I die three times, it's going to ask me for my name. So 1, 2, 3, game over, ask for your name. So I'm going to say Ed, and it says best player high score is 4. So if you play this game again, oops, and you don't beat 4, let's say I only get 1 or 2, and I die again, nothing happens. But if I beat that high score, so three, four, five, and I die now, game over, then it's asking me for my name with my high score. Okay, so that's step one completed. Step two of this tutorial, what we want to do now is store the high score and the player name into the text file. And we're only going to do this after the game has ended, and that the player has scored a higher score than the current high score. So what we do is we declare a variable called file num as integer, and this is underneath the timer one tick event handler, and we scroll down to where it says if score is bigger than high score, and previously we've already asked for the player name. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna open the file num. We're going to open a file called score.txt, and the open mode is going to be output because we're saving into the file. Now notice how file num hasn't been defined yet. So it's an integer, but we don't know what number it is. So we need to use the free file function, and that'll tell us what is the next file number available, which is going to be 1 because we don't have any other files open. So, and then we're going to print line, so we're going to print to the score file with our player name, and we're going to print to the file our high score, and then we're going to close the file. So that's all pretty simple, and let's just see if it works. So we're gonna play the game, gonna get a couple of gems, die. Okay, game over, ask me for my name, John, and my high score is 3. So I'm now gonna browse to that folder of my game, which is located in Documents, Visual Studio 2010, Projects. My first game won, Bin, Debug, and you can see that I have score.txt. So I'm gonna open this up, and it has John 3, which is the high score currently. So we have successfully saved the high score to the file. Step 3 of this tutorial, we want the program to load up the name of the player and the previous high score from the score.txt file at the beginning of the game. Right, so we know what our goal is to accomplish when we're playing, what score we have to beat. Okay, so we're going to go up to the beginning of the program. When Form 1 loads, what we're going to do. So I'm going to firstly declare file num again. Remember to do this every time you need to access the file. And I'm going to use the free file function to tell us the file number that is available, and then I'm going to open up the file with that file number, and it's going to be score.txt. That's the name of the file. The open mode is going to be input, right, because we're only reading the file, and we're gonna store the name of the player, which is going to be the first line from the file into the player name variable, and we're going to store the high score in the high score variable. Oops, spelled this wrong. Lucky there's a spell checker thing. So I have stored the player name inside this variable, the high score inside this variable, and I'm going to make the a label display the player name from the file, and I'm gonna make the high score label display the high score from the file. Okay, so if I play this game now, what's gonna happen is if I start the game, you can see that it loads up the high score 3 from the previous game. So if I get 5 and I die and I call myself something else, Ed, oops, so make sure you jump out of that. There was a mistake that I made earlier, which is at the beginning when I was programming it to load up the player name, I forgot one last line, and that was we have to close the file. File close, file now. And without that, the file is still going to be open, which won't allow us to modify it later on in the game. So we're going to try it again. So we're going to play it. Start game, it's got John 3, so I'm gonna get 5 and I'm gonna die 3 times. Okay, game over, I'm gonna call it Eddie. And then I've got Eddie 5, so if I close this game down and I run it again, it comes up with 5 Eddie in the beginning. Right, and if you check the text file, Alright, go into the folder here and then check the text file. It says 85 as well. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you again next time.